YouTube, man, for some reason my goddamn webcam isn't working. It's okay, we're fine. You're gonna see my ugly ass face right now. You guys are getting 3 videos today, and I have to go to work, so I'm trying to get these out before 12 o'clock. So I'm gonna show you guys, this is my new God Squad. This is like damn near 10 million coins. This is actually 8, actually. 8. I had 8 million coin shots for y'all boys, man. I didn't upload it, I didn't record it. I do all my stuff off camera, I do some stuff on live stream. If you guys haven't already, check me out on Twitch. I do be live streaming over there sometimes, so. This is the new God Squad, y'all. Like I said, I spent a lot of money. Too much fucking money, to be exact. But I say it's worth it because I get decent pulls. Better pulls than I thought I would get, honestly. But let's go to the O-line. I had the dude from the Green Bay Packers. If you guys have him, quick sell his ass immediately. He is garbage. Ass and barbecue. Okay? How do you pick up Trent Williams? Even though he's 86 overall, his stats are better than him. He's 87 overall. Either get him or Joe Stanley. I think that's the... Heavyweight. I was going to pick him, but I picked Trent Williams because he's 10K cheaper, and, you know, I just picked him. At the left guard position, I pulled Bruce Matthews out of my packs. So, I did that or I completed a set, but I think I pulled him. One of the best left guards, or actually the best left guard in the game. I think I had one of the best all-lines, okay? Hands down, all right. Bruce Matthews, 87 strength, 89 awareness, 88 pass block, 86 pass block power. Basically 89, 88, so basically 85 and above for passing. That's freaking amazing. I'm pretty sure he go people like the D tackles like Kenny Clark and stuff like that, Daryl Dockett. So he gonna be going against some of the inside guys. If you put Aaron Donald in there, he should be able to hold his own. I got at the center position, I got Travis Frederick. I pulled him. These centers are fucking expensive, especially with the themed diamonds. They are so expensive. So I think he's one of the third highest center or second. I don't know, but I got Travis Frederick. I had Rodney Hudson, but I wouldn't even get Travis Frederick. So Rodney got him. I believe he has, basically anything 80 above except for his pass block defense. So if anything, his ass would be next to getting replaced. I don't think 70, so I'm sorry. I don't do that. At the right guard position, we got Larry Allen. I pulled big ass Larry. Larry. Basically 85 and above everywhere. I pulled him. Pretty beast card. One of my first legend linemen. Or was it Bruce Matt? I think he's my first legend lineman. At right tackle, I forgot who I had. I think it was another from the Packers. He was a right. This is an 84 overall. I had to pick up Lane Johnson. I'm sorry. Them tackles have been effing me. I promise y'all. That's why I've been getting sacked so damn much. I had to pick up Lane Johnson. He's a beast. He was a beast in Madden 16. I'll play with him. Freaking God. Let's go to the tight end position. I got Zach Ertz. What did I do? I did the solos, and I got Zach Ertz, which I'm kind of happy about. I didn't have to spend $200K on a whole new goddamn tight end. So I had the best tight end in the game besides Winslow. So I wanted Winslow so damn bad, I just don't know. I still might pick him up anyway. If I get some coins, if I get 600K coins, I'm picking up Winslow. And then Delanie Walker can go to the third. I'm quick to Travis Kelce, sorry ass. But Zach Ertz is a fucking beast, trust me, y'all. At the receiver, we got Jerry Rice, y'all. Jerry Rice is a beast, that's all I'm gonna say. I believe he has 87 speed. We got Marvin Harrison, 89 speed. I think one of the fastest receivers in the game. Him and I believe Terry Holt, if I'm correct. I think Tyreek Hill has 89 speed as well. At the running back position, I brought Todd Gurley. Beast ass card. This card is the best card in the game. The X factor makes him, when you juke with this guy, it's just ridiculous. All right, trust me, this card is nasty. I pulled Marcus Allen twice. I sold one of them. I kept one because for some reason my second halfback gets in. I guess because of the specialist tab. He's my third down running back or whatever, but he gets in. So that's why I kept me a beast running back. Third, I have Le'Veon Bell. I had Saquon. I had Jim Brown. Like I said, I had some beast-ass running backs, okay? So I had them. So, yeah. Quarterback Patrick Mahomes. He's wish-washy with me, okay? That's all I'm going to say. I want Steve Young, or at least a Kurt Warner card. I think that Kurt Warner card is a fucking monster. Only problem is can't fucking scrap, okay? But he's throwing a run for Patrick Mahomes is just nasty. It's the only thing I like best about him. He's throwing a run. But it's a pretty good card. I changed his X-Factor. I used Zach Ertz instead of his because I rarely throw the ball 30 yards deep. I'm afraid I'm going to get fucking picked off. I don't know why. His throwing animation is so fucking slow. You guys just don't know. Fullback, I got Anthony Sherman. I pulled him. I don't know, eventually I might change my fullback position, but some of the formations I run, I substitute Marcus Allen in anyway for play action and stuff like that. The backup for the running back, for receivers, I got OBJ, 89 overall. You can say obviously one of the best card arts in the game, and also one of the best receivers in the game. I like his route running. I think he has 87 speed. When I get Torrey Holden 90, he will be in my slot. So we're gonna have some deadly receivers, y'all. And I got AB. Hey, he had to get replaced. You couldn't get no fucking separation, y'all. I'm sorry. You couldn't get no goddamn separation. And I have Emmanuel Sanders flashback as a last resort. I think he got in once. The defense. We got some goals on defensive squad, y'all. See, that Von Miller cost me an arm and a fucking leg. I should be at fucking a mill right now. But that Von Miller cost me so damn much. I might end up selling him back. I'm thinking about it, honestly. But at the free safety position, I had Ken Houston. It put him to 86 overall. I was going to put Harrison Smith over there because I'm making an 87, but I don't want to get extra, so I kept him over here. But I went ahead and got the Eddie Jackson power-up, one of the highest safeties right now, if I'm correct. I think him and Earl Thomas. So, 88 overall for Eddie Jackson. He was fucking slow. I had to upgrade him, so. And I also got Ken Houston come off the bench. Devin McCourty gets in some of my formations. One of my first legends is that I completed for a set was Derrick Brooks. Derrick Brooks is a fucking beast. Hit power, he can cover, a god. I got Uncle Bobby. Damn it, Bobby. Bobby Wagner. Brought him for 150K. Pretty good card. It's between him and Luke Kuechly. But I got him because he's significantly cheaper. Lucas had the X Factor, so I might end up getting him. I just have Bobby as a backup. It just depends on how I feel right now. But right now, I'm keeping Bobby. It's pretty good. I like him. Like I said, I got Von Miller. I might actually sell him simply because I do run 3-4. I do run 4-3 sometimes. So he gets in. But I feel his impact, but he doesn't do it. Like, I said that wrong. He's there. His presence makes things bad. But I feel like he doesn't do as much as I think he should have on an overall card. But if I didn't have Strahan or Reggie White or Lawrence Taylor, he would definitely be on the D-line. But since I already have them, no, I was using Anthony Barr as a user. The only issue is with Barr is that he has no power. He has nothing. Oh, he's good for coverage. He can't. His pass, his finesse and power was so terrible. Harrison Hitman Smith, that's all I gotta say. He hit power, he intercepted for your boy. This man has 88 speeds, so that's why he's not starting. But I like Harrison Smith. Best corner in the game, Stephon Gilmore. He's pretty good. He gets a lot of picks for me. He's playing man coverage. Yeah, Gilmore's gonna be on that. I got Mel Blunt. He was my second corner, but he's pretty good as well. He gets a lot of picks. Sometimes he bet the safety position in some of my formations. This bitch has to go. He has to go. I am licking my, like I told y'all last time, I'm licking my fucking chops for this bitch to go. I want him gone. Damn. I got LT Lawrence Taylor, y'all. This man's a fucking beast. He was a beast in Madden 16 when I had him. He's a beast now. He gets down and dirty. I got Reggie White. Completed his set. He's a 90 overall, but he dropped to 83. I had Kenny Clark, Sheldon Richardson, and Darryl Dockett, but it's too damn slow. I'm sorry. Guys, put some of these players out of position, because some of these players sucks ass. I'm not saying a lot of y'all. They fucking suck. Okay? They're slow. Okay? They have like about 60 to 70 fucking speed. At least they have 76, 78, damn near 80 speed. So I will put somebody out of position if you can. I put Aaron Dock D-tackle. He goes crazy as well. I got the gap to his bastard, Michael Strahan. He goes crazy as well. So if you guys can put him out of position, trust me, it will help out. Put Khalil Mack, possibly Von Miller. Trust me, it will help you out. Also got Uncle Willie. Uncle Willie don't play that shit. And that's really it for the squad, man. This is a guy squad. This is my kicker, my punter. It's the only thing that's really down. It's keeping me at 87 overall. I had so many kickers and punters. I just sold them. I don't need them. If anything, I'll get another kicker. So I can kick better. So get like maybe 50 yards, maybe. Cordell Patterson, bitch ass, really gotta go. I would be getting Tyreek Hill soon, but do not know when. But Tyreek Hill will definitely be my key returner. And this is my specialist. This is what I run. Eventually I gotta change this because I'm tired of Marcus Allen. Yeah, that's why he gets in for the power. Okay, that makes a lot of sense now. That's why his ass gets in. And that's really it. So I hope you guys have. This is my playbook. I will be giving you guys some playbook tips for Ultimate Team. I guess the best five playbooks you use in Ult. So, I'm sorry. So, I hope you guys have a blessed day.